Hi there, the eccentric Phil Thomas Cat, and this is Tommy Robinetti.
And this is the Uncharted Zone.
That's right. We have a great music video right here for you. This is one of those summer re-entries. It's a good tune. We shot it at the top of the town over there at the corner of Jefferson and
Intendencia. We like saying that. I don't know why.
It's the cool word.
Rolls off the tongue. Intendencia. Nonetheless, here's Space Junkie with a summer re-entry. This is called Heavy on UZTV.
Music videos produced, and if you want, I'll be in it too.
The UZ request line is now open, and we're taking your calls at 453-KATT. Call me.
The most popular jam session on the coast, Jamsies, 9401 North Davis Highway, invites you to attend the Friday afternoon jam session. The Gulf Coast Darts Capital, 9401 North Davis Highway, Pensacola.
Ragtime Grill on the corner of Jefferson and Intendencia is open Monday through Saturday at 11 a.m. Enjoy the flavors in this great downtown restaurant. Ragtime Grill is also a lounge and package store with a good variety of product. Ragtime Grill, 201 South Jefferson Street. That's the corner of Jefferson and Intendencia, downtown.
After eating dinner, buy your bottle and party all night at 15 East, top of the town, just next door.
Tomorrow. I like the atmosphere. It's really great. I like the trains, and it just looks great. The outside looks real good, too.
I like the chicken. It's really cool.
Hey, folks, I'm Kevin. Stop on by Granny Cantrell's for some good southern cooking.
You're watching UZTV. I'm Phil Thomas Cat.
And I'm Tommy Robinetti. And now it's time for what used to be Phil's Pick, but we don't call it that anymore, because he doesn't always pick what we like. And, well, last week we got into a wrestling match, and yeah, we tore some stuff up, and, you know, it was fun wrestling, you know, but the wear and tear on the... Anyway, take it.
You know, a while back I went out to a 1971 high school reunion for Catholic High. And the band Lyman Slack was playing. Now, this was one of the most popular bands back in the 70s here locally. I mean, they opened for Lynyrd Skynyrd. They played open for Blood Rock and lots of cool things. Nonetheless,
cool.
They did a reunion show this night for the high school reunion, and it was really good. Usually made it out there and had a chat with the band.
With the legendary rock band Lyman Slack. How you guys doing tonight?
We're great. Wonderful.
I hear that y'all were one of the hottest bands back in the 70s here in this area. Tell us a little bit about that and how y'all felt about those days.
Can't say much. It was fun.
Yeah, back in the 70s, so you know, you might not remember much, you know.
It was good to us. We had a great time.
Who was the front man for the band back then?
John Pfeiffer.
Both sang and, you know, played guitar together.
Okay, now I'm going to hand y'all the mic, so I want y'all to introduce yourselves for everybody.
I'm Steve Gunter, man about town. And I was not in the band originally, but I'm honored to be playing with these guys. They're some of my favorite musicians I've ever worked with in my life, and I'm just glad to be here to help in the festivities. Love you guys.
That's how we feel.
I'm Greg. I was the keyboard player.
Still are.
John Pfeiffer, and sang and played guitar.
Yep.
Father John LeCarry, and I was playing guitar and writing songs, too.
Yep. Yeah, and doing a fine job. Robert Fillingham, the bass player, and I'm just happy to be here and to be doing this again. I'm surprised I lived this long.
Gary Nichols, and I'm the drummer, and I've been with these guys, I guess I started back in 74-ish, and played to about 79, and loved every minute of it, and glad to be doing it again.
Yeah. And this is my understudy.
What's up?
My son, Keaton.
And we saw a picture, an old poster in there with Wet Willie, and of course y'all's name was on there, and Lynyrd Skynyrd and everything. Tell us a little bit about that concert and how that went.
That was an outdoor concert that was held at the racetrack and
Five Flag Speedway.
Oh, that's right.
Uh-huh.
Was that the name of it?
Yeah, that was cool.
All right, and we played. I guess we played before Lynyrd Skynyrd. We were just one of several bands, and we did a mixture of original material and then some cover tunes. We did the Who. What else did we do? I don't
Does anybody remember what songs we did at the raceway? Five Flags.
Mostly Johnny's tunes.
Mostly
his songs.
I know we got a write-up in a national magazine, too. You remember that? I don't remember what it was called. Bobby Anderson brought it to us, and we got written up something that followed concerts, like a review of outdoor shows.
What was that? What was that again?
Walrus Magazine.
That's right. Sure enough.
Good somebody remembers.
Yeah, see? There's still a brain cell or two of firing.
Now, other than that concert, what were some of the best events or just parties that y'all played? Anybody?
I think one of the ones for me was when we played the Municipal Auditorium in Pensacola, and we opened up for White Witch, and that was a really good show. And the other poster that's in there was just made prior to that, probably made less than a year prior to that.
Yeah.
Now, when did the band originally start?
69.
68 or 9?
When 69. It started with John Pfeiffer, Greg Hebert, myself, a drummer called Lance Lynch, and Robert Fillingham, and the five of us were together for 5 years. And then Lance left, and we had another drummer called Mike Smith for a year and a half or so. Then we had Gene Burleson.
Briefly,
we had Bobby Taylor, who was with Beatlemania for one night.
Yeah. Yeah.
And then Gary.
Then we found
Gary the Great.
Somebody that would hang. Gary Nichols. Yeah, that was good.
Now, what were some of the clubs that y'all played at here in town?
Here in town?
And around.
The Beacon.
Night Owl.
Night Owl.
Yeah, what was the one on Garden Street? The Bandbox. Remember, it was Clyde's place.
Yeah, sure enough.
Remember that one?
That's their place.
The quarterback club. Yeah, we played Machine Guns, too. A lot in South Florida down there.
Yeah, we toured all over Florida. Did some dates in Alabama and Florida, Louisiana.
Shaving cream fight in Cocoa Beach.
Yeah.
I saved his life, by the way.
Saved Father John.
He's grateful.
Yeah, he is.
Grateful, yeah. We opened up for other concerts, too, at 71. It was Ted Nugent and Blue Oyster Cult. And then in 72, we opened up for, who was that now? REO Speedwagon.
Yes, that's right.
And
Blood Rock.
Blood Rock.
Yeah.
Blood Rock, right.
DOA was the big hit. Remember that?
Right. So we were focusing on a lot of original material at that time, too. And then we moved on and started playing in different places and traveling in the southeast, south mainly. Yeah.
What made you decide to go into the music business, and what are you doing now?
Well, it's a good question. Music kind of just comes to you, and you, if you're a musician, it stays with you. And so I've done it all my life. I spent about 20 years out in California, and then just recently got back with these guys, and I had this opportunity, and I certainly appreciate it. And we love playing together. I worked as an engineer a bunch of years out in California, and now I have a dojo over in Milton, Academy of Martial Arts. Thank you very much.
My music started as with piano lessons as a child. And it's my mother's fault. She gave me the Beatles. I don't remember what's the album with the black half faces.
Oh, Meet the Beatles.
Meet the Beatles. She gave me that album, and so then I was hooked on the Beatles. And the first time I saw a different photograph of them, it was a picture of Paul McCartney holding a bass, and I didn't know there was such a thing. And I saw that picture, and I went, "I've got to find out what that is." And when I found out what it was and the way it sounded, I was just hooked. I didn't want to play guitar. I didn't want to play the piano in the band. I wanted to play the bass. And so I have. And I still am. And my musical career has been multifaceted. It's probably the most polite way to put it. But it's come full circle. Now I'm a worship leader at my church in Pace, Florida, at Woodbine United Methodist Church. I'm the music director there. Yeah, it's awesome. God's been good to me, in spite of my misbehavior.
And you?
Music. I come from a musical family, and so I was brought up with the desire to just play and to write. And, of course, when the Beatles came out in the 64, I saw that and went, "Hey, that looks like something I'd like to do." And then we met, some of us met in 68, 69, and it was... rock and roll, more songwriting. When I left the band in 74, I still pursued a career in music, mainly focusing on songwriting and playing as a soloist and teaming up occasionally with other musicians. And then throughout that time, I was also having other things happening that were making me hear another call. And that call was to the priesthood. I was ordained a Catholic priest. June 28th, 2002, and currently serving as a parochial vicar, an associate at Nativity of Our Lord Catholic Church.
Oh, you
very
are the
happy.
Vicar.
I am the vicar. Yeah, it's a joy. And so we're back together playing for Pensacola Catholic High's Class of 71 reunion. The last time we did this was 5 years ago.
I was just inspired, just like the rest of them were, you know, with the music of the time, and loved to sing, and that's, you know. it's just good to be back with them now. I mean, I don't do it for a living or anything right now, but it's good to be with them right now.
Well, my parents forced me to take piano lessons at the age 5, and I'm 53 now, so I think they regretted it when they found out what I did with it, but I enjoyed it. Just enjoyed playing, and now I'm work for the school system in data processing.
Well, I, like all the rest of them, I was inspired at about 12 or 13 by the Beatles and all that sort of thing, but I also liked Simon and Garfunkel and things like that, and the guitar situation for me I found an old guitar in my grandmother's garage and pulled it out. I didn't know what the heck it was, but I loved it, and it was my cousin's first guitar, and he just gave it to me, and I had it for a couple of years before I ever did anything with it, and then I started hearing all the records that we all have grown up with, and that's why I did it, especially when I heard the blues. That was the thing that made me start realizing that I had to play the guitar, that that was what I was supposed to do. And that's what I've done pretty much with my whole life, and still trying to do it, and I'm just honored to be playing with all these guys. They're some of my favorite musicians on earth. And the last time we did this together was one of the finest moments of my entire quote career that I ever had, because we just, I think, I don't know about for them, but for me it was one of the best ones I ever had on a stage in my life. And I'm sure tonight's going to be the same thing. It's just going to be fabulous. Anyway, Steve Gunner.
Y'all tell me, out of all of y'all, tell me who are some of your favorite local bands back then whenever y'all were playing.
Well, for me, these guys, I loved them. Zigzag, and there were many versions of Zigzag, but I'm talking about one of the earliest versions, which was a band that inspired me to no end, because of Terry Blackwell, my buddy, on the drums, and Cecil Clark was the bass player, and there was a guy named Tony Duran, who was their guitar player, and he ended up going with Frank Zappa for a few years, I believe. But anyway, those are some of my bands that I loved, and just the bands that I got the good fortune to play with in my earliest days, you know, like the Scoundrels, versions of the Scoundrels and all. I could go on for days with band names. We're blessed in the Pensacola area to have such great talent, and it's an unfortunate thing that it's taken for granted so much, but this area has always had, I think, more than its share of really great musicians, and luckily I've gotten to play with a lot of them over the years, and still am tonight.
Okay, you?
I think the Chords are one of my favorite groups. Judd Camille's was around. Haley's band.
I thought the Chords were good.
The Chords were real good. I'm trying to think of anything. Freddie Garcia, the Scoundrels, they were very good.
Mark
Osmond.
I don't know what the name of the band was, though. I can't remember.
Susie Storm, the Layman. Yeah, Susie Storm.
They were good. Mandela as well. I forgot about them. They were.
That's who they were. Heavy Weather was the name of
it. Is that what it was?
Yep.
Okay, and for you, other than some of the ones that they've already named?
I can't think of any more.
The same one. We all hung around together and went around listening to the same folks.
Yeah. Now I'm going to get y'all to repeat it for me, because I was over here and y'all were over here and I couldn't hear you, so y'all tell me.
The Chords, for sure, and the Garcias are the ones I was most aware of.
Yeah, that would be it for me too, the Chords, absolutely. I was amazed by, I can't remember the guy's name, the bass player for the original Chords. Yeah. Rick Tolliver. Yeah, man, he was awesome. He really... He drove me to play better. Just from listening to him, I said, wow, there's more to do.
And you?
I don't know. I'd probably have to say Zigzag was probably one. And though they weren't that popular, Lynyrd Skynyrd at the time, you know, we're talking back in the 70s, they were a local band. And they, you know, so good Southern rock, and we, you know, took after a lot of it.
The UZ Top 10 is based on our request line, Talk on the Street, and the UZ Artist Survey.
Husky Charlie's, one of Pensacola's finest dining establishments, invites you out to experience what everyone is talking about.
Please come in and order one of our signature steaks cooked over mesquite charcoal. Listen to our live bands on Wednesday and Thursday night. We also have outside dining and a outside saloon.
Husky Charlie's, 5901 North W Street, Pensacola.
Jane's Lounge.
represents one of the tightest bands on the coast, Crossfire. Come out and dance, party, and have a good time at June's Lounge, 3810 West Navy Boulevard, Pensacola.
Everybody knows CJ's Kitchen and Grill on Garden Street has a great breakfast, and their lunch menu is quite the treat, too. But did you know they're now open late night on Fridays and Saturdays? If you're a late night person, then grab some grub after the club, and you'll see what the daytimers have been raving about. CJ's Late Night at CJ's Kitchen and Grill, 2100 West Garden Street, Pensacola.
Welcome to the Neighborhood Hair Hut, a local landmark since 1974. We offer all types of hairstyling services for men and women. Our nail technician, Cindy, can also attend to your manicure and pedicure needs. The Hair Hut also features Cinderella hair as well as Pro Hair hair extensions. So please, come see us all at the Hair Hut, 8950 North Davis Highway, 477-2439.
Local music, local bands. It's the Uncharted Zone. Love it like you should.
If you can't be home for the UZ Top 10 Countdown, Saturday at midnight, tape it.
Tell me that it's all right. Who else besides Jesus forgives? When there's dust on the Bible and dirt on my soul again.
Take your love to town.
Pine Forest Road, open Tuesday through Saturday at 4 p.m. Happy hour 4 to 8 every day, with Ladies Night on Wednesday. Plus, live music from Freestyle, Wednesday, Friday, and Saturday. Fox Landing also hosts karaoke every Thursday night at 8:30. Fox Landing, Pine Forest Road at the I-10 exit in the Roadway Inn. Fox Landing, a really cool West Side bar.
The Legends Bar and Grill inside the clubhouse at Perdido Bay Golf Club might be off your beaten path or even a little hard to find. But once you do, you'll be glad you did. There's a happy hour Monday through Thursday, 4 to 6 p.m. and a great breakfast and lunch 7 days a week. They also serve dinner every Friday night from 5 to 9 p.m. with a new menu every week. The Legends Bar and Grill. Come on by. It's open to the public.
My name is Dan Story, food and beverage manager at the Legends Bar and Grill. Inviting you out to come see us.
Been doing business here 20 years and having a good time doing it. Warm beer and lousy pizza at Pop Rocker.
Keep in touch.
I'm Michelle Kernley, and this is UZ News. The Jazz Society of Pensacola will present Jazz Fest Goes On Saturday, August the 12th from 6 p.m. to 9 p.m. at Seville Quarter. Featured artists will be Crystal Joy, Roger Valines, and Joe Acapini's Big Band with an appearance by the Swing Kids. This is a semi-annual fundraiser for Jazz Fest, a two-day free concert in Seville Square, March 31st through April the 1st, 2007. For more information, visit jazzpensacola.com. The Lillian Community Club, right across the bridge on Highway 98, is having jam sessions every Sunday afternoon in the month of August from 2 to 6 p.m. All musicians and singers are invited to attend. It's a brand new club, and it's a very versatile event. Some of them only do rock and roll, and others only do bluegrass. But they all come out and have a good time. In weeks to come on the Uncharted Zone, more classic footage along with more requests and morning music videos from the UZ New Entry Playlist.
This cool music video is part of the Jay Hawkins DVD, entitled Seriously, I'm Just Joking. It's packed full of footage focusing on Jay Hawkins through the years, including this more recent music video that guest stars produce. This music video was shot in Mesquite Charlie's over on W Street and features the talents of Paul Ewing, who performs there on Wednesdays and Thursdays at 6 p.m. The tune's a classic Johnny Cash song, and the sizzling you hear in the background is coming from these great big steaks they're cooking over Mesquite charcoal.
Where do we go from here?
This UZ Summer Reentry was put together back in 1998 and features this very talented singer-songwriter. Robert was performing in the area regularly at the time, but has since disappeared from the local music scene. The tune's an original and was very popular when it was first released, so it will be interesting to see how it does without the support of his live local performances. This footage was captured at a Jazz Society event a while back and showcases the talents of this well-known Pensacola entertainer. Red's been singing in the area for years. His latest gig is with drummer Ted Johnson at the Bayview Community Center, where they perform every Friday night at 7 for the over 55 club dance. This music video was released earlier this year and showcases a Mike Roycroft original that's from the Late Bloomer CD. The video did real well last spring, and that's why we've returned it to the survey as this year's last summer reentry.
When all those bright lights fade, I'll be so glad that I stayed here to hold you tight.
The Knee Deep Band is back in their latest incarnation, and they're ready for action. This footage was shot at the Islander on Pensacola Beach, where the group has been gigging lately. The song's a classic, and lead singer Tomato nails it in her cool bluesy style.
Saturdays at midnight is the weekly UZ Top 10 Countdown Show, and last week's number one was Crossfire. Remember, if you can't tune in, record it. And coming up next Friday at 4:30 p.m., the latest new entries to the Uncharted Zone.
She was too young to fall in love, and I was too young to know.
This footage was shot at the Ragtime Grill on the corner of Jefferson and Intendencia in downtown Pensacola. former New Orleans musician J.B. Davis performs there Thursday through Saturday starting at 6 p.m. The tune's a classic Sam Cooke song, later recorded by Dr. Hook, so it's real cool to hear it again after all these years. In fact, Mr. Davis's song list is full of things you don't hear that often, so his performance was a real treat.
All I know is the way I feel.
This music video was shot at Avalon Recording Studio in North Pensacola and features one of the brightest news stars to the area. Crystal Miller is the daughter of Gulf Coast legend Ronnie Miller, and she currently performs with the local band Crossfire at Jean's Lounge on Navy Boulevard. The tune's the title track to her new solo album that features all different styles of music, including this techno track.
As always, contact me if you have any local entertainment news by phone or at theunchartedzone.com. For UZ News, I'm Michelle Carnley.
UZ TV. Pass it on.
It's Floribama Lounge is open and the magic is back. The deck stage is rocking and there's live music there on a regular basis. The deck is also enclosed and protected from the weather. There's also some cool stuff happening across the street at the Silver Moon Songwriters Cafe. The Silver Moon was the main connection to the Bama after the storm, and it has become a songwriter hotspot. The Silver Moon stage, the Bama deck stage, and a tent stage on special occasions is the way to get the Bama experience the way it was meant to be.
Corolla, owner of A&K Furniture, 2600 North T Street. Please come visit us and see all this beautiful Indonesian furniture.
Living along the Gulf Coast has its advantages, the beautiful beaches and warm sunshine, but that can all change in a matter of hours. It's hurricane season again. Are you prepared? Be sure before any watches or warnings are issued for our area that you have supplies on hand like bottled water, 1 gallon per person per day, non-perishable and canned food, a manual can opener, flashlights, batteries, a first aid kit, a 2-week supply of prescription medicine, ice, and insect repellent. For a complete list of items, visit theunchartedzone.com, or for more information on hurricanes, visit NOAA.gov. This has been a public service announcement brought to you by Cat Productions and UZ TV.
Don't let your favorites go unvoted for, but every 24 hours on the UZ Artist Survey at theunchartedzone.com.
Find out who's gigging where on the live local lineup page. It's as easy as theunchartedzone.com.
Move all around, even jump up and down. Go anywhere without any cares. Do all the moving that you want to do, but stop. I didn't say go.
Let's go.
Find a friend now, do it again. Move all around, even act like a clown. Do all the moving that you wanna do, but stop. I didn't say go.
Let's go.
I didn't say go. I didn't say go. Listen to your teacher, cause I didn't say go. Do all the moving that you wanna do, but stop. I didn't say go.
Let's go now.
That you wanna do, but stop. I didn't say go.
Let's go.
I didn't say go. I didn't say go. Listen to your teacher, cause I didn't say go. Do all the moving that you wanna do, but stop. I didn't say go.
Let's go.
Show your body to show how you feel. You got to move to make it real. Do all the moving that you wanna do, but stop.
I didn't say go.
Let's go.
Stand and turn, but don't get hurt.
If you can't be home for the UZ Weekly Top 10 Countdown Show Saturday nights at midnight, you better tape it. Or I'm coming over to your house and I'll do it for you.
The woods, even a ball game, if it could, just to watch the children play.
Corolla's Limousine and A&K Furniture.
They are one of the longest-going limousine companies in Pensacola. Reliable, friendly, same prices for 4 years. Take a look at their newest 10-passenger limo.
Telephone us at 470-0030 and find out about our competitive package rates, Biloxi rates, anniversary specials, wedding specials. I can go on and on. Just call us and we'll let you know.
CJ's Kitchen and Grill has become Garden Street's best breakfast restaurant, and according to their parking lot, their lunch is great too. CJ's Kitchen and Grill, 2100 West Garden Street in Pensacola, is open Monday through Saturday, 6 a.m. to 2 p.m. Not only do they offer some of the best food around, but the staff is among the friendliest in town.
Hi, my name is Jermaine. I want to invite everyone out to CJ's Kitchen and Grill. Enjoy our home-cooked meals daily, Monday through Friday.
Grab some grub after the club. CJ's Late Night. Fridays and Saturday.
The UZ Top 10 is based on our request line, Talk on the Street, and the UZ Artist Survey.
Blues Angel Music, Pensacola's number one guitar shop, is the only store in town that specializes in used guitars, amps, and accessories. There's all kinds of cool musical stuff at Blues Angel Music. And unlike those music superstores, Blues Angel Music is home-owned and operated. Drop on by, whether you're buying or selling. Blues Angel Music, 3733A West Navy Boulevard, next to Zoners.
When choosing a vet, consider
my favorite favorite place because my mom and dad worked here. I feel it's
open in a ring of fun. Whiskey Charlie's, one of Pensacola's finest dining establishments, invites you out to experience what everyone is talking about.
Please come in and order one of our signature steaks cooked over mesquite charcoal. Listen to our live bands on Wednesday and Thursday night. We also have outside dining and an outside saloon.
Mesquite Charlie's, 5901 North W Street, Pensacola.
The music continues on the Uncharted Zone.
Some have your eyes of blue. They've in the mood, and it's just an imitation of you, baby. Some have your all, your sweet sexy tone. Some have your eyes of blue. They all got that look, but honey, I'm in the mood.
The Silver Moon Songwriters Cafe, across from the Floribama on Perdido Key, is becoming Songwriter Central in the area. If you're a songwriter or a lover of original music, this cool spot's the place to go. Many a great songwriter has graced the stage of this establishment. Even songwriter legends have performed here. Don't miss the magic. The Silver Moon Songwriters Cafe, across from the Floribama on the Key.
Hi, I'm Vanessa, and I work here at Granny Cant Trails, where the food is great and the service is better. Come out and see us sometime.
My name's Ashley. Y'all should come down to Granny Cant Trails. It's a great place, good food, southern cooking. Hope to see you.
Hi, this is Samantha. Y'all come on down to Granny Cant Trails for some great food and even better service.
Hey, folks, I'm Kevin. Stop on by Granny Cant Trails for some good southern cooking.
This next song is a group called 60 Cycles of Sound.
Now, this is a real popular band in the area. In fact, they're one of the nominees for the independent newspaper, their music awards that's coming
up. Well, very good. Now, this is an old version of, a new version of the old Go-Go song.
But they ain't the Go-Go's, I assure you that. These guys rock.
So here they are, 60 Cycles of Sound, and we got the beat.
You know, not that the Go-Go's didn't rock. They had their own way of rocking. But they didn't rock like this.
You are singing. Yeah. You're going to sing on this one, right? You're going to sing on this one, don't you know? You got to let your mother's know. That Bobby's going to be. You got to let your song. We're going to play the horse. You're going to beat that. There it is right there. It's got to be the name. It's an oldie, it's a goodie, but it's not a fair idea. I'm doing it. I got that old.
We got the beat!
You're out there on the skate ramp. Come on, I know you.
We got the beat!
No bikes now.
We got the beat!
Somebody out there does.
We got the beat! Come on! We got the beat!
I think Stella needs to come up here and sing with
us. We got the beat!
Let me buy you again!
On your feet!
We got the beat!
Let me buy you a chance to this! We got the beat!
The trap up!
What'd y'all think about 60 Cycles of Sound?
They were amazing.
Crazy.
Yeah.
They were crazy, like amazing.
Freaking bam.
The weekly UZ Top 10 Countdown Show, starring Phil Thomas Catt and Tommy Robinetti. Michelle Carley investigates UZ News. UZ VJs Brittany White, Ashton Shane, Felicia Qualls, Tiffany Gard, Nancy, Masha, and Sarah Brown. UZ music journalist Mike Roycroft. The top 10 music videos of the week. And a whole bunch of commercials to pay for the show. And now, the star of UZ TV, Phil Thomas Catt.
Hi there, I'm Phil Thomas Catt.
And I'm Tommy Robinetti, and I was looking away.
We certainly hope you enjoyed the show this week. If you'd pay attention, you'd know it's almost over.
I know, I was looking to see if somebody was washing my car, because that's part of the gig. When you come and do the show, somebody washes your car. It's pretty cool.
Yeah, it's one of the VJs.
Oh, is it?
Yeah.
Oh. Okay, well,
it'll be spotless.
Will it?
Yeah, it should be.
That's cool.
Please join us again Saturday night at midnight. We'll count down the top 10 local music videos for you, as we do every Saturday night at midnight and every Friday afternoon at 4:30. It's the Uncharted Zone, as it has been for
10 years.
Wow.
10 years.
Keep in touch.
And then one day you find 10 years have got behind you. Profound.